job training program in Chittenden County is giving new skills to a non-traditional workforce. They are non-violent offenders housed in a state correctional facility. And as News Channel 5's Jack Thurston reports, the whole community may see benefits.
A big job site, a fresh coat of paint.
It's been enjoyable.
And perhaps a fresh start for Bobbi-Jo Hodgdon.
It's been a great opportunity.
During the day, she's been working here, but this is where she spends her nights, in a prison cell in South Burlington, Vermont, following a conviction for extortion.
Being in jail obviously isn't enjoyable, but when you get to be part of a project like this where people appreciate it, it kind of gives it reason, I guess.
Hodgdon is part of a job readiness program that teams the state's corrections department with the nonprofit Vermont Works for Women.
They start to think of themselves as successful and as achievers rather than just as failures.
Jolly says counselors back at the facility help the inmates on career exploration, crafting resumes, and building interview skills. This group also took part in training to prepare them for trades, including lead paint removal. But Hodgdon hopes the sense of teamwork she's been developing will transfer to a different area when she's released in December.
I really want to do something with culinary.
It turns out Vermont's one correctional facility that houses women is its most expensive to run, costing Vermont taxpayers about $80,000 a year per inmate. Corrections officials tell us one of the reasons it costs more to house women than it does men is because women tend to require more medical attention.
So the logic goes, if inmates get a career boost for life after prison, they'll be less likely to reoffend, meaning a more secure community and cost savings for the state. Another win here, the Intervale Center's Barn Improvement. The group promotes sustainable, healthy, local food systems.
If we can find ways to partner with others in our community to meet our mutual goals, then you know, I think Vermont's a better place for that.
And Mary Howard says she's better for having taken part in this program.
I'm 44 years old and haven't got my GED yet. So I've been working on it since I got here.
After serving time for shoplifting and drug-related charges, she'll be out in 2 weeks and wants to stay clean and take college classes.
I have big plans. Hopefully, I can follow through with them.
The barn work may have helped plant a seed, but it's up to the women to make sure the concepts learned here grow into a steady job, into a brighter future. In Burlington, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.